Back on the show, it's time for our Neblett, Beard, and Arsenal legal difference segment. And have you been injured on the water? And Wes Gralapp joins us now, the attorney, an attorney with Neblett, Beard, and Arsenal, to kind of educate people about maritime injuries and the Jones Act. So, Wes, good to see you again. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me, Mark. Today we're talking about a subject that is near and dear to my heart. Mm-hmm. My father was a tugboat captain, and so he qualified under the Jones Act. Yeah. What makes a person a Jones Act seaman, if you will, is whether or not they are contributing to the mission of the vessel and whether or not they spend the majority of their time on the vessel.
Yeah.
Once injured as a Jones Act seaman, you have special accommodations by the court. We are all familiar with a workers' compensation scenario, right, which is available to us on land. If you are injured on a vessel and you are considered by the law to be a Jones Act seaman, then you can actually file a lawsuit against your employer if your employer was negligent and that negligence caused your injury.
Yeah. Now, how are you protected under the Jones Act?
Well, the court started by recognizing that these men and women are subject to the perils of the sea and needed special protection.
Right.
So they're considered to be wards of the court. So if a vessel is unseaworthy, then the vessel owner is responsible for that. Or if your coworker is negligent and causes you an injury, then your employer, who is often the vessel owner, is responsible for that. Mm-hmm. Often we see these scenarios in the drilling industry, the offshore drilling industry.
Offshore, exactly, exactly.
And, there's a subtle difference between what is considered to be a vessel and what is considered to be land, if you will, even though this platform may be offshore.
Yeah.
And so typically the best definition that you can look at is if the platform is connected to the seafloor, if it's connected to the bottom of the Gulf of Mexico and not capable of movement, then it is not a vessel. And you're not afforded a remedy under the Jones Act if that's the case. You're considered to be a longshoreman.
All right. Now, if one suffers an injury, a maritime injury, what should they do?
They should contact an attorney who's qualified to handle these things, because the subtle differences can mean a lot in whether or not you're entitled to compensation and what type of compensation you're entitled to.
Yeah. If you're injured offshore, what type of compensation?
Well, there, if you're a qualified Jones Act seaman, then you're eligible to receive your pain and suffering, your lost wages, your medical bills, and you're also entitled to what is called maintenance and cure. Maintenance and cure is that amount of money it would cost the vessel owner to house and feed you on the vessel while you're working.
Yeah.
That would be the maintenance part, and the cure is for any medical expenses that you would incur to get well from your injury.
Yeah. Say also, if you're injured on an unsafe vessel, what then?
Well, if the vessel is unsafe, we call it or refer to it as being unseaworthy, then you don't have to be a Jones Act seaman in order to recover damages against the vessel owner. So any part of a vessel, whether it be a ship or an offshore rig or a pleasure boat, if it is unseaworthy and causes an injury to an employee on the vessel or what we call a passenger is a seafarer, someone who is being transported by boat over water, then that person is entitled to sue the vessel owner for that unseaworthiness that causes injury.
Okay, if you're injured on a rig, are you protected under the Jones Act?
If that rig is considered a vessel, you're absolutely protected.
Okay.
Otherwise, you're still protected under the Longshore and Harbor Workers' Compensation Act. That's why it's important that you call a qualified attorney if you're out there working and you suffer an injury, because the subtle differences between what is a vessel and what is a platform makes all of the difference in the compensation you're eligible for.
Got it. Okay, we'll continue this discussion next week. I find it interesting that your father was a tugboat captain.
Well, thank you. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm sure he had some interesting stories to tell.
Always.
Reaching out to Neblett, Beard, and Arsenal, the best way to get in touch with you, Wes?
If you're hurt working offshore, call us 561-2500.
All right. Thanks again, Wes.
Thank you.
More to come.